Close to you, Maria, like a child I want to be. Take me in your arms and in my walk guide me. I need you to teach me and show me how to pray. Make me transparent, fill me with peace every day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So good morning. Welcome to Parishioners of St. Mary's, those who are visiting and those who are watching this Mass through St. Mary's Ottawa YouTube channel at 11 o'clock today. And today we celebrate the Feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe, Patroness of the Americas. And so I'm going to be speaking about that in my homily today. And as you see, there's the image of Our Lady of Guadalupe. Brothers, sisters, let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of hearts, Lord of mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May mighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. We'll do the Gloria. Okay. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God, the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God, Father of mercies, who place your people under the singular protection of your Son's most holy mother, grant that all who invoke the Blessed Virgin of Guadalupe may seek with ever more lively faith the progress of peoples in the ways of justice and of peace. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Revelation. In my vision, God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of His covenant was seen within His temple. A great portent appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. Then another portent appeared in heaven, a great red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 diadems on its heads. Its tail swept down a third of the stars of heaven and threw them to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman who was about to bear a child so that it might devour her child as soon as it was born. and she gave birth to a son, a male child, who is to rule all the nations with a rod of iron. But her child was snatched away and taken to God and to his throne, and the woman fled into the wilderness, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The responsorial canticle. You are the greatest honor of our race. You are the greatest honor of our race. O daughter, you are blessed by the Most High God above all other women on earth. And blessed be the Lord God, who created the heavens and the earth. You are the greatest honor of our race. Your praise will never depart from the hearts of those who remember the power of God. May God grant this to be a perpetual honor to you, and may he reward you with blessings. You are the greatest honor of our race. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. Blessed are you, O Virgin Mary, for your firm believing that the promises of the Lord would be fulfilled. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today, as I said, is the Feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe. And so Mary appeared to Juan Diego in December 9, 1531. So in 11 years, we're going to be celebrating the 500th anniversary of the apparition of Our Lady of Guadalupe. Okay, so what's the context? What's the context when Mary appeared to Juan Diego? The Spanish, they just, you know, they were in Mexico and they were trying to evangelize the people there with not much success. Okay, and the people there, they're worshiping the sun god, the moon goddess, the stars, you know, so they're worshiping that. And what they would do also in that area, in Tepeyac, which is in the outskirts of Mexico, they have those pyramids. And on top of the pyramid, they would sacrifice babies. They think that to appease, you know, to please the gods, their gods, they need to offer up sacrifices of humans, of babies. Okay? And of course, babies, they're sinless. They're a perfect sacrifice. Okay? So what happened there is that it's like in the pyramid, you would see blood flowing from the top going down with these sacrificing of the babies. So not much conversion happening. There are very few. And then one of those few is this Mexican person. When he got baptized, he got the name Juan Diego. And he was 57 years old, a widow. So that's the context. So on December 9, Mary appeared to her. And this is what Mary told her. Okay? So Mary told her this. My dearest son, I am the Eternal Virgin Mary, mother of the true God, author of life, creator of all and Lord of the heavens and of the earth. And it is my desire that a church be built here in this place for me, where, as your most merciful mother and that of all your people, I may show my loving clemency and the compassion that I bear to the Indians and to those who love and seek me. So Mary asked Juan Diego to go to the bishop to make this request to build a chapel there. Of course, Juan Diego, being obedient, went, and the bishop didn't believe him. Said, "I need a sign." Okay. After that, Juan Diego went to visit his uncle who was so sick. He's about to die. So what happened there is that he decided to go to Mexico City to go for a priest to be able to anoint his uncle. And he was supposed to meet Our Lady, but he went the other way of the hill. He said, I'm going to try to avoid this lady, right? So he tried to avoid, and then Mary appeared to her, to him again. And then, so he told Mary that the bishop is asking for a sign. He said, okay, go. Okay, so she asked Juan Diego to go to the top of the hill in December. So this was December. Okay, so this is December 12th. And December, it's winter here right now. And in Mexico, it's not that cold, but still cold. And on top of the hill, the climate is also colder. So he went there. And he saw roses. And during that time, like, roses is not the season to have roses. So he gathered the roses and he were wearing, the Mexicans, they're afraid of the cold. So they like to wear this kind of like blanket around them. So they call it tilma. So he gathered the roses, put it in the tilma, and then Mary said, "This is the sign. Show it to the bishop." Okay, so he went to the bishop and when he came before the presence of the bishop, he presented the roses, he opened the tilma, the roses fell, and then this image of Our Lady of Guadalupe was there in the tilma. What happened there? The bishop fell on his knees and started to cry because of his disbelief. Okay? And this image is miraculous because it's made of cactus fiber. And usually the cactus fiber would last only 60 to 7 years and it will disintegrate. 500 years, close to 500 years, still there, intact. And when this image was shown to the native people, they picked up the message at once. Okay? They worship the sun god, they worship the moon goddess, they worship the stars, and you see here, Mary appeared, right? Mary is in front, blocking the sun. Mary is standing on the moon. What Mary was wearing is full of stars. So they know this lady is more powerful than their gods. Okay? And then they saw a ribbon. It's like a black ribbon there. It's not a black belt. Mary is not a black belt of taekwondo or karate. The native people, when the native people are pregnant, they wear a black ribbon, symbolizing that they're having a child. Okay? And that, when they saw that, they realized what they were doing of sacrificing babies is abominable. So they stopped. They stopped the sacrificing of the babies. Okay? And what happened there is because of that, in a span of a very few years, 9 million Native Indians converted to become Catholic. Okay? So, and so after that was that, again, going back to Mary meeting with Juan Diego, right, on the seminar. And this is what, because Juan Diego was concerned about his uncle, okay? And this is what Mary told Juan Diego. Listen, okay? And let it penetrate your heart. Do not be troubled or weighed down with grief. Do not fear any illness or vexation, anxiety or pain. Am I not here who am your mother? Are you not under my shadow and protection? Am I not your fountain of life? Are you not in the folds of my mantle? Okay, in the crossing of my arms? Is there anything else you need? And Mary told Juan Diego that your uncle will get well. And of course, you know, after meeting with this bishop and showing this image on his tilma, he went to visit his uncle, and his uncle got healed. Okay? And he asked what was the time. And it was the very same time that Mary told him that your uncle will be well. And in fact, Our Lady appeared to the uncle and introduced herself as Our Lady of Guadalupe. So that's where we got the name Our Lady of Guadalupe. Okay? And so it's a beautiful thing, you know. And I think it's first, that's why, you know, there's so much abortion happening in America, even in this country, right? We know how many babies are being sacrificed out of the god of convenience. You know? People are saying, I'm not ready to have a baby. Sacrifice. God of convenience. That's why we need to ask the intercession of Mary. Imagine there in Mexico, all the sacrificing of the baby stopped when they saw this image. So we need to pray for that. The second thing is, Juan Diego was so worried about the health of his uncle. And the message of Mary there, he says here, you know, do not fear any illness or vexation, anxiety or pain. Am I not here who am your mother? This message is not just for Juan Diego. This message for each and every one of us who are experiencing fear right now because of this COVID-19. Okay? Who are experiencing a lot of anxiety, a lot of pain. or any illness that we have. Mary is telling each and every one of us, am I not here who am your mother? So let's have recourse to Our Lady of Guadalupe. She's not just the mother of the Mexican, she's the mother of us all. We could turn to her. And when we turn to her, you know, it should really calm our very fears. Saint Therese of the Child Jesus in today's Living with Christ, she wrote this, in trial or difficulty, I have recourse to Mother Mary, whose glance alone is enough to dissipate every fear. So we offer up now our intentions to the Lord our Father. We pray for Pope Francis, that the Lord would grant him the wisdom that he needs, and also for protection that he needs from the attack from the enemy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all bishops, priests, deacons, religious, that they would be faithful to the calling that God has given them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Mexican brothers and sisters there in Mexico, that they would continue to have this great devotion to Our Lady, and also not just for our Mexican brothers, for all of us, you know, to have a great devotion to Our Lady of Guadalupe, our mother. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, you know, that they would experience a miraculous healing through the intercession of Our Lady, our mother. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are living in fear, right now, living in anxiety, depression, any mental illness, suicidal thoughts, we pray for that mother's, our Lady's presence will be felt, that will calm their fear. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died. We pray for their salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of this Mass, for the repose of the soul of Ella and Ethelbert Modeste, offered by Keith and Vanessa Doherty. Let us pray to the Lord. God our Father, during this Advent, help us make straight our path so that we may be prepared for the coming of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. All right.
pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the gifts we present to you on this feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe, and grant that this sacrifice may strengthen us to fulfill your commandments as true children of the Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At a time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Marcel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Saint Juan Diego went to the mountain.
Alabare, alabare, alabare.
Let us pray. Lord God, may the body and blood of your Son, which we receive in this sacrament, reconcile us always in your love. And may we who rejoice in Our Lady of Guadalupe live united and at peace in this world until the day of the Lord dawns in glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I think I heard it from Father Mark that Guadalupe means the woman who crushed the serpent's head. Okay? Is it correct? Yeah. Okay. So let's ask for her intercession, and especially in these difficult times. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you in him, humbly pray. And that our Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.